your head, then you're down. And I don't care what the politicians spout. If you need a companion, why just go out by the pound? Invite yourself a hound and make that dog get proud. Because that's what it's all about.
Hi. Welcome to Rescue Roundtable. I'm Mary Catalano, and we have a very special guest today who's done something really wonderful. I'm very excited about having her on the show. My guest today is Shannon Keith. She is the producer and the director of a really important new film called Behind the Mask. Welcome, Shannon.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thank you for coming, and thanks for all you do. Shannon, tell everybody how you started out and what you do. You're an animal rights attorney also, correct?
Right. Okay. Right. I'm an animal rights attorney. Mm-hmm. So I sort of cover the gamut. I do civil, criminal, administrative hearings where I get dogs off death row. I defend activists and prosecute people who abuse animals. But I got involved in making this movie because I didn't feel that I was making enough change in the courtroom. Mm-hmm. I was saving animals one by one or helping activists one by one. But we have this horrific political climate that we're in where people are being repressed, and we need to get the message out there. So I wanted to make a movie for activists to inspire them more and for the general public to actually learn about what happens to animals and what happens to people who help animals.
And it's a really big, and it's really big and really important. And I saw this, and it's like, it's killer. It's fantastic. Why do you think it's important for everybody? Here's our cover right here, if you can see this, Behind the Mask. And Shannon, how long did it take you to make this film?
It took a little over 3 years. Uh-huh. It was a long process. It took about a year to collect all the underground and undercover footage. Mm-hmm. And I was still actually getting anonymous footage sent in to me as I was, in post-production, so adding stuff in, and then I traveled the world for a little over a year, and then it was the post-process.
So why do you think it's important for everybody to see this movie?
there's a lot that people can learn by seeing this movie, even if you're an activist and you already know things, and especially for someone who really doesn't know much about what happens to animals, you learn a lot about what happens to animals for food, what happens to animals for testing. And you learn about those people who actually risk their lives and their freedom for animals, people that are anonymous, that don't take any credit for their actions, but they do break the law because they feel that it's justified for a greater cause. Mm-hmm. And we don't know who these people are. Nobody mm-hmm. knows who they are. Mm-hmm. But what was great was I got to interview people who have already been convicted of those actions so they could mm-hmm. freely speak about them. And it was very interesting to actually look at those people and hear their stories. I was so moved. And for people to understand, these are not terrorists, as our government says. These are compassionate people who are willing to risk their lives. It's more than most people can say for an idealistic view.
Now, the media is pretty much, they're pretty often jaded, what did you learn while you were making the movie? I mean, it's the media, I know, we all know it's jaded against anyone doing this type of a movement. Because they say it's all radical and violent, which is absolutely incorrect. So.
Right. Well, the media likes to take a sexy topic and blow it out of proportion. Mm-hmm. So we've seen that happen with the Animal Liberation Front. We've seen news footage, there was a 60 Minutes piece a couple of times, where they really characterize these people as terrorists.
Yeah.
They never show the animal rights side. They never show the liberationist side.
Right.
They're constantly being approached with show this, show that, show why these people are doing this. But they don't. And the media has a responsibility to the general public, and they don't do it. They're not responsible.
Right. It makes them all look insane and, and violent, and that they're doing something really crazy. And
if the media were responsible, they'd actually draw comparisons to other social justice movements and say, well, maybe it's justifiable. Maybe it's understandable. We saw this with the women's rights movement. We saw this during the civil rights movement. We saw this, in all of our social justice movements in the past, people breaking the law, more radical factions to actually make a difference.
And that's how change happens anyway.
Right.
Civil rights was like a big deal. What do you think people will take away from the movie that you're gonna?
Well, I've gotten a lot of feedback doing some private screenings.
I went to the premiere of the movie here in LA, and it was packed, and it was like, it was like, afterwards everybody just like couldn't speak because it was so well done.
Thank you.
It's just I had to buy some. I bought a couple. I want everybody should see the movie.
Yeah, I think people, from, the comments that I got back, they were very moved. They learned a lot. They were angry. They were shocked. But what's best about the movie is it's got all of the elements. It makes you cry. It makes you laugh. It makes you angry. And it inspires you. Mm-hmm. And, people had different side effects of the movie. People went vegetarian. People went vegan. People changed their views about the Animal Liberation Front, mm-hmm. and saw them as compassionate activists. People
right.
were inspired to do more in their daily lives rather than just not buying cruelty-free products. They're getting active and doing more. And ultimately, I want to change the way that people think. Mm-hmm. People need to question the media. They need to question the government's motives.
Right.
Why are they trying to draw attention away from the real terrorists and focusing on these so-called domestic terrorists?
Right, right.
What's going on? People need to think about that. Be intelligent.
Right. Now, people are going to be afraid of some of the footage in the movie, and yet I saw the movie and I was afraid of it, except that you're telling me it's like about 5 minutes worth of footage that's more disturbing.
Right, yeah, people have been concerned, like,
yeah,
oh, I don't want to
watch the movie.
Yeah,
I mean, there's so many people, oh, don't, I can't go to the pound, I can't go, I can't do this. I'm
right.
like, you know what, it was so well done, it's so effective because, and amazingly enough, it was a small amount, but it had a
right.
great impact.
Yeah,
which is really,
I was sure to do short cuts,
yeah.
So you see enough cruelty, right,
yeah.
you see enough cruelty to make you angry, but it doesn't drag on,
right.
But people need to see what's going on so that they can justify breaking a law,
right?
To help these animals.
Right.
So that's important. And yes, it's in a 72-minute movie. It's only 5 minutes of actual animal cruelty.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable, but because there's a point totally gets across. Now, a couple of people died during this movement, and you mentioned to me, we were talking earlier about the man mm-hmm. who died on a hunger strike. Can you talk about him?
Well, yeah, there's been a lot of people who have died for this cause, and. There was someone in England named Barry Horn who was a direct action liberationist. And mm-hmm.
Did he go into labs and take animals and so forth? What did he actually do? Do you know?
He did a lot of different things.
Okay.
I don't know exactly if he did that. But he actually died on a hunger strike in prison. And there was also a woman named Jill Phipps who's profiled in Behind the Mask.
Mm-hmm.
I interviewed her mother in England, and she was killed. She was run over by a slaughterhouse worker bringing animals into slaughter.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. So, what do you think about our current political environment? I mean, is this like gonna?
I think it's a very scary world that we live in right now, and people need to be aware of what's mm-hmm. going on. Activists are being bombarded with threats from the government, on the federal level and the local levels. We're seeing this with our comrades with the Shack 7 federal indictments, where
The Shack 7. Because
Shack 7 is there's a campaign called Shack, Stop Huntington Animal Cruelty.
Oh, yes, of course.
Right,
okay.
And they're trying to close yes. down a lab called Huntington Life Sciences.
And where is Huntington located?
Well, there's one in New Jersey,
okay.
and there's one in England.
Okay.
So there's a Shack UK and a Shack USA.
Okay.
But the feds have been after, Shack USA forever.
Mm-hmm.
And they indicted 6 individuals, including the organization, so that's why there's a 7, on under the Animal Enterprise Terrorism Act. This is the first time this act has ever been used. And basically what it says is if you interfere with an animal enterprise, you can go to prison. And what they've done and what our government is doing is completely wiping out our freedom of speech. The entire prosecution was based on their website, protected speech.
Wow.
And they were convicted of these federal crimes. They're being sentenced on September 12th, and they're probably all going to prison.
It's based on their website?
It's based on a website.
What was on the website? I mean,
well, the
we
website
still have
was,
freedom of speech. So.
Well, you would think that we
Hello?
Do. But the scary thing is that we're learning that we really don't. It's just like England. In England, you're not allowed to say you support illegal action. So in England, if I were to say I support the Animal Liberation Front, I could quite possibly be arrested. That is what's happening here. Basically, they said the website was a direct threat. because it targeted certain individuals who abuse animals. And they were saying that that led to people going to their homes and illegal actions from happening. So although they could not directly link any of the defendants with any illegal actions, they just linked it to the website.
Wow. So now what do they do at Huntington that people are not aware, because people don't know about this?
Right. Huntington is the second largest research contract laboratory. So what they do is companies like Procter & Gamble will hire Huntington Life Sciences to test Colgate on monkeys. Mm-hmm. They do mostly pharmaceutical, household goods, and cosmetics. Mm-hmm. They've been the subject of three undercover investigations. They've been cited by the USDA on several occasions. They had employees fired for animal cruelty. This company needs to close. Mm-hmm. It's quite clear. And we have undercover footage of it in my movie, Behind the Mask, where you can see lab workers punching beagle puppies in the faces.
Yeah, this is what I couldn't believe. Beagle puppies. Like,
right.
People go, oh, I always want a beagle. I'm like,
right.
Excuse me? They use beagles. And why do they use beagles? I mean, this is like one of the people's favorite animals, pets.
They use beagles because they're small, because they don't bark very much, and because they're very trusting and loving, and that's the saddest part.
Well, that's like all dogs.
Right. It's all dogs, but beagles are easier to handle.
That's unbelievable. I mean, that freaked me out totally. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh my God, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, they raise beagles for testing.
Yeah.
Somebody breeds them and sells them to these guys.
Right. They have contracts with different breeding facilities where they're specifically bred to live a life of torture and die.
That's unbelievable. I mean, what inspires you to fight, you know, for this cause, for the underdog, for the animals? What?
Wow, so much. I mean, I look around me, and it's difficult now with all the knowledge that I have to watch TV, to watch a movie, just to look around at what's going on outside and not be pissed off that people aren't doing more to change things, to make things better. You know, there's so many people fighting on behalf of humans.
Right.
Everyone's interested in human causes.
Right.
We have enough advocates for human beings. We hardly have any for the animals.
Right.
They don't understand. They don't have a voice. We need to be their voice.
Right.
And they can't wait and sit around for us to write polite letters to the government or to legislators.
Right.
You know, action needs to happen now.
Right. And people think, and people, believe me, well, of course I hate people because I've been at the pound a lot, but what do you think that is this movie, I think, is going to make people change, and the more people see it, the better. I mean, I really highly recommend it. You think it's going to make a change? I mean, you were an animal rights attorney, and did you always want to become an animal rights attorney? Is that why you went to law school?
Yes.
Was that something?
It's the only reason I became
a lawyer. Oh, really?
It
is. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
To change the law, because animals are considered property in the law, so I wanted to change that.
There are very few animal rights attorneys out there, aren't there?
Very few. There are some people that call themselves animal lawyers, but they're different. There's very few animal rights attorneys. But what would be really interesting is for people to actually watch the promo.
That's right. I almost forgot.
And
let's do it.
Yeah.
We want to see the promo. I forgot about it completely. I'm really sorry. I'm so spaced. But yeah, I'd love to show. We want to show part of the film. This is the trailer.
This is the
correct?
Trailer. Yeah,
okay.
For the movie.
So please take a look at this. This is behind.
The ultimate goal, stop vivisection, stop animal experimentation, stop any type of animal exploitation. That's the ultimate goal.
Police say the arrested protester faces two misdemeanor charges.
Can you tell us a little bit about your history of arrests?
If I could go back in time, I would do the same thing again.
I am not afraid of being arrested because it's nothing compared to what the animals go through.
I was acting as a liaison between the underground and the above ground.
The apparent target of British laboratory, Huntington.
I might have to go back to jail. I might be killed. But that is part of being a warrior.
Oh my God, my
the reason that masks are worn is simply because the activists are smart enough to know that they need to live to fight another day.
What bothers me and what keeps me awake at night isn't going back to prison. It's the suffering of the animals in these places.
I didn't have any idea what to expect when I first got the job in the laboratory. I omitted that I worked for PETA.
You know, every animal is an individual.
Oh, my God.
And you know, they've got a right to a life and to be free from pain and suffering.
We busted their operation.
Well, we intend to stop them from going into the ice pack. If that includes having to ram them, yes, we will.
I think there's nothing more punk rock than the ALF.
Just made up my mind to do something.
Slash dot dash dot slash dot dash dot slash dot dash dot slash dot com. Dot com. Dot com. Dot com. Slash dot dash dot slash dot dash dot slash dot dash dot slash dot com. Slash dot dash dot slash dot dash dot com. Dot com. Dot com. Slash dot dash dot slash dot dash dot dot com.
How you got started.
Is that still running?
FBI calls these animal liberation activists domestic terrorists.
You know, when I see an innocent beagle puppy being punched in the face, you know, in the name of toothpaste, money, coffee sweetener, those people are terrorists. They're terrorizing innocent lives. That is terrorism.
One thing that I know that separates us from the people that we are constantly accused of being, that is terrorists, violent criminals, is the fact that we have harmed no one.
They call us terrorists. But nobody in our movement has ever hurt a living thing. We've had four of ours get killed. One was my beautiful daughter, but I can't talk about her.
So in other words, you're willing to kill people, are you? Is that what you're saying, over? Well, if you kill anybody, I'm holding you personally responsible.
The profit they're making from killing animals in the first place can either be tempered or sometimes countered by economic sabotage. So the money they're making from animals, it's no longer cost effective.
Well, what we deliberately go out to do is to protect marine mammals. And if that involves confrontation, then so be it.
When you drive by UCLA or Cedars-Sinai, those pretty walls there and the lawns, behind that, the horrors do take place.
I think beagles are a common choice for animal testing because beagles are generally friendly, they're a small breed, they don't take up a lot of room, and it's really unfortunate because if you think of all the breeds of dogs, who would rather be out running around in the sunshine and sniffing grass and trees and playing than a beagle?
You're out of the woods, you're out of the dark, you're out of the night. Step into the sun, step into the light.
Hold on to your heart, hold on to your home. March up to that gate and leave it open.
had my grandson in jail. I've been to jail.
Captain, this is the Sea Shepherd. Do you stop killing whales?
Climbing up on Salisbury Hill, I could see the city light. Wind was blowing, time stood still. Eagle flew out of the night. He was something to observe.
For God's sake, get up, go out, fight. Stop it. We've got to stop it.
I had to listen, had no choice. I did not believe the information. Just had to trust imagination. My heart going boom, boom, boom. Son, he said, grab your things, I'm going to take you home.
Larry David. Wow. Shannon, fabulous. It's fabulous work. I want people to see it. Now, what are your plans now? You're going to be promoting the movie. You're sending it to Sundance, right?
Right. I sent it in to Sundance. It's being pitched around. I'm going to be traveling with it all over the U.S. and throughout Europe. Mm-hmm. There's activists all over the world that are translating it and showing it to, you know, people in Israel and Hebrew and people in Germany and Sweden and Italy. It's very exciting having...
It's really important. And you have a website. What's your website?
It's uncagedfilms.com. Mm-hmm. And you can go there and just read about the movie. You can purchase the DVD on there as well.
You can purchase the DVD, which mm-hmm. is really good. Okay.
Yeah, and this movie was produced by my nonprofit organization called ARMY, Animal Rescue Media and Education. So we make educational films. We also rescue animals when we can. We do what we can to get the word out there about animal exploitation and those who fight for them.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So how long have you had the organization? How long?
I've had ARMY for a while, but we went nonprofit in 2004. Mm-hmm. So it's been about 2 years now that we've been a nonprofit.
So it's very exciting. How people receive the movie, like they're blown, right?
Yeah. I mean, this movie It's exciting because we've got real footage in there.
Yeah.
You know, this is, it's real stuff. You see people going in, smashing computers, breaking into labs, getting animals out. You see real rescues happen. And it's exciting. It's, you know.
Now, why do you think people don't have any idea, but they're still buying fur, which is unbelievable.
It's unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
It's...
Well, that's, you know, part of why I made this. Uh-huh. We tend to live in a bubble and not know that people don't know a lot of things.
Right.
You
right.
know, people need to be educated. Someone saw this movie and said, "Oh my God, I thought they only tested on rats." Someone had no idea they actually test on every kind of animal imaginable. Mm-hmm. But we have to understand that some people really don't know.
Right.
But once they know, then it's their responsibility to change their lifestyle.
Right. So we have some testing going on at UCLA too. Right.
Horrific.
What's
testing.
Going on at UCLA? Because people have no idea about that.
Well, at UCLA, there's a lot of testing for a lot of different reasons. But the worst, the absolute worst, is for drug addiction. They test on primates and cats, and they've been doing the same tests for years on drug addiction. We do clinical trials on human beings for
right.
that.
Right.
What the hell is still going on with that? It's so frustrating.
Is it about money? It has to be about
it's
money.
It's about money.
It's not about
anything else. They
don't need
else.
The information anymore. They already have the information. It's about somebody having a house or something.
Right. It's about writing as many grants to get as much money as possible personally and for UCLA or for whoever they work for. It brings in money that they can use for whatever they want, typically. But there's no excuse. There's no excuse for that kind of torture.
And what are they doing? They're doing vivisection. Are they doing vivisection there?
Yeah, they're doing
which
vivisection
people don't know
as well.
What vivisection is.
Right, vivisection is testing on a live animal, usually without anesthesia, with the intent to, you know, induce stress. And how that makes any sense when you compare that to what's going to happen to a human is beyond me. And you know, you're taking an animal in a certain type of environment where they're stressed out. Stressing them out even more.
Right.
And, you know, we have several doctors that have said, you know, not only do animals differ from species to species, but
they're not us.
They're not us, exactly. And, you know, many human beings have died because tests on animals have revealed I mean, tests on animals have revealed they were safe on animals. Then the drug gets let out, human beings take it, and they die. Mm-hmm. Because their systems are different than
different
ours.
System. Yeah, pretty obvious there.
It's pretty obvious.
Unbelievable. It's unbelievable. Yeah. So the cats and primates, you're saying, at UCLA.
Yeah, well, UCLA has everything. I saw a list of the animals. You wouldn't believe it. They've got, like, emus and donkeys. They've got every animal imaginable at UCLA. But I don't know about the tests on all of them, but I do know about the cats and primates. And it's very sad.
So it's happening right here.
Yeah.
And is there any hope that Huntington will be shut down, or is it just a matter of the word getting out and people complaining and activists?
There's definitely hope. You know, they went almost bankrupt several times. Mm-hmm. They got kicked off the stock exchange. People are learning about them, and there is a good chance. So the fight is still continuing.
We have very little time left, but I want you to know, can you tell me some of the major companies that do use these facilities so that people can start thinking about not buying their products? Procter
sure.
and Gamble. Like, I have a IMS brochure that I always don't use IMS at my adoptions. I give that out, but I don't know who all. Do you have some of the names of the big companies?
Well,
and
what
products?
People should do is they should go to like, the PETA website,
PETA's list,
exactly,
okay,
and
to
see
find out cruelty.
The companies that do and the companies that don't, because the list is humongous.
They have a list of cruelty-free
yes.
people.
Yeah. Yeah, and you can order a brochure, and they'll send you a free packet, mm-hmm. and you can get that information that way.
So you can boycott on your own and,
right.
not,
people,
and start
right.
giving out the information. I
right.
mean, it's a Procter & Gamble, and I don't know, some of the big, Eukanuba is made by somebody.
Right. Yeah, there's so many. I mean, there's just the list goes on.
I mean, that's just
know.
Like a simple thing you can start doing.
Right.
But people need to, you know, people are going to be seeing this film. I know it. And it's going to be very important.
They need
and
to think about the products they buy. They need to think about the food they eat, the clothing that they wear, and what they believe and what they don't believe when mm-hmm. they read the newspaper or when they watch the news. And they need to start taking action because mm-hmm. it's starting now with the animal rights activists, but it's not going to stop there.
Right.
It's going to invade people's personal lives that have nothing to do with this.
Right.
Because, like I said, our freedoms are being taken away, and it's a scary time, and people need to start fighting back. So they need to see this movie. They need to see Behind the Mask, and they need to get angry and inspired and start taking action.
Mm-hmm. So I want to thank you so much for what you did, which is yes. you've made it's fantastic that you've done this movie because it's so important, and it's I know it's going to change things for the better.
Thank
it's
you.
Really important to see Behind the Mask. Here it is again, you guys. It's going to be coming around. It's going to be at film festivals. It's probably going to be on a major network at some point, right?
Hopefully,
Showtime,
yeah.
Whatever.
People can go to the website and check to see when screenings are in your area.
And again, so what's the website? One more time.
It's uncagedfilms.com.
Okay, Behind the Mask. Thank you, Shannon.
Thank you
for doing the film. I really appreciate it, and thank you for coming to the show. And
thanks for having me.
Please refer people to we got your footage up here, so fantastic. Thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you next time.
Just a walk in my dog.